Hey guys, this is my dog. And I know that my omelet video has been blowing up lately, so I decided we're gonna kick it off, get back into making videos. Start off with some duck leg omelets. I know it sounds crazy, but we tried making it yesterday. Marcel, what do you think? It was fire, right?
I love it.
So, I mean, we have a little Asian duck recipe and we're gonna see what happens. Before I kick this video off, I just wanna say that I have a new channel that I've been working on. My dog is mad because he knows it's a great channel and he doesn't want you guys to know about it. So, the name of it is Go There. I'm gonna be working on a lot of more just life stories and just personal advice. And honestly, if you're ever feeling, I'm gonna actually bring him outside. 1 second. Come on. This is Julian, by the way. He gets really mad at everything, so I'm gonna bring him out. It's okay, buddy, we're gonna go outside, all right? So what was I saying? Oh yeah. So, if you're ever feeling, you know, like you just wanna know your purpose, because I can teach you how to cook, but I wanna show you how to cook, you know what I mean? So if you're ever feeling like a little lost in life, check that channel out. It will be posted down below in the description. It's all really just my personal life experience and I wanna share it with you guys. It's definitely brought me a lot of light into this world. So yeah, let's get started on this duck recipe, baby. Two duck legs. We're gonna do like 350 degrees Fahrenheit, about an hour and a half, but this is a small one, so I'm gonna start it at an hour, check on it, see how crispy it's looking. So come on over here. I'll show you one and then we'll do the other one. Let me just get in here. Okay. So take this baby out, right? We don't just cover it with salt first.
Oh, Barkle, you want to go outside too now.
My friend over here, she wants to go outside too. Say hi to the camera. They're trying to ruin my videos. They're always in the background of all my videos. Like trying to be the Bob Ross of cooking, you know? Can't have too many barking in the background. All right, so I got some toothpicks. Gotta be more organized, right? And what we're gonna do is we're gonna simply puncture the skin, like boop, 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 boop. Because there's a lot of fat inside and we want that fat to sort of come out. That way it's not locked in and we can get a really nice, crispy, tasty skin. Bump, 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 bump. Generous amount of salt because salt draws out moisture and brings more crispiness, right? And so if your pepper grinder ever breaks, you take your peppercorns whole and you just smash them with a wooden spoon, boom, you know? So that's what happened to me. And just season it very generously. Whatever you would have is what you will season it with, you know? Don't ever feel pressured to season it with too much or too little. My best advice is when you're gonna cook something for like maybe a family, try making a small portion for yourself and see how you like it, you know, so you can really taste it the day before. That's what we did. And see if there's something you want to change the next day. Because for example, we made the duck omelets with duck breast and it was really good, but a little chewy. And I prefer eating duck breast sort of on its own with like a little bit of sweet potato or something like that. So we're switching over to duck legs. All right, back to the other side. Just a quick seasoning.
Yep, 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 yep. Some pepper.
Yep. Two beautiful duck legs. And we're just gonna simply put them in the oven, right? Boom. 350. See you in an hour. Actually, in the meantime, we're gonna do a little bit of prepping.
All right, so I made three different sauces and the base of them is simply just mayo and hoisin sauce. I don't know if you know this, but hoisin goes amazing with duck, so get your hands on that stuff. This is simply just strictly mayo, hoisin, and a very tiny bit of that Tabasco chipotle pepper sauce. Really good, a little smoky flavor. This is the addition of barbecue sauce right here. And here we have a little addition of tomato ketchup along with, you know, the classics. So we'll see which one my boy Marcelo out here likes the most, and that's how we will judge which one we're gonna use today. Hey Marcelo, come in here. They're all pretty good. I love them all, but
yeah, bet.
Let's see. All right, first one, that's our barbecue-based one.
Mm.
And they all have hoisin and mayo in them.
It's good? Already hard because this is already so okay. Good.
All right, so this one is simply just Hellman's real mayonnaise, real mayo, right? The real stuff.
Real.
What do you think of that one? That's the simplest one. It's like strictly that with a little bit of Tabasco, chipotle.
I think that was going to be a hard decision.
And then this one is the same thing, hoisin mayo, but a little bit of ketchup. Just give it a little bit of a tang, you know? Because I love ketchup and eggs. It's a tough one, but we got to come down to one. Or we could just have them all. Why not? but if you were to choose one of those, you know, for our audience right here who's watching, which one would you say that you love the most? Like, just give them an idea.
This is a hard choice, though, but I have to say... I'm more inclined to the first one.
All right, the barbecue.
Yeah,
so.
I tasted the duck yesterday, and I had feeling that
barbecue. The barbecue, baby. Down below in the description, I'm gonna have the ingredients and names of each sauce, just so you have an idea of what's in it, and you can try making them all yourself. But barbecue is Marcelo's choice by popular demand. That's what we're going with today. Alright, so I'm doing a little technique before we get our little B-roll, or chopping the ingredients. What you do is you take a paper towel and you wet it, you know, not too much. Slap it on there. The other one right here. Boom, boom. Soak it out a little bit. Unravel it. Slap that baby on there. Take your cutting board. Alright, like that. And boom, it doesn't move. Well, maybe a little bit. So, let's get our knife. Boom, 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 right over here. Okay, so quickly, the ingredients I'm gonna go over. We got some cabbage, a little bit of sweet potato. This is an optional ingredient if you don't want it too sweet, because I know some people don't like too sweet. Some shallot and shiitake mushrooms. Also, pro tip, I'm home growing my own green onions, and whenever you buy green onions from the store, all you have to do is when you're done using them, cut it up to, like, I don't know, like 2 inches, whatever. I don't know, up to you really. And just put it in a little bit of water and it will just regrow. I just used some yesterday in my practice and these guys are growing really big. Oh, there he goes again. B-roll time.
Olha que coisa mais linda, mais cheia de graça. Ela, menina que vem, que passa. Doce balanço, caminho do mar. Moça do corpo dourado, do sol de Ipanema, o seu balançado é mais que um poema, é a coisa mais linda que eu já vi passar. Ah, por que estou tão sozinho? Ah, por que tudo é tão triste? Que existe a beleza que não é só minha, que também passa sozinha. Ah, se ela soubesse que quando ela passa, o mundo sorrindo se enche de graça e fica mais lindo por causa do amor.
Thank you.
So we're gonna start with our little sweet potato thing that I'm gonna make. It's like a hoisin sweet potato with shallot.
We got our pan going at low heat. We're gonna grab a little bit of oil. And we got some sesame, so we got olive and sesame. What we're gonna do is we're gonna add our aromatics first. So we got our ginger and garlic, and then we're gonna add in a little bit of our shallots and finish it with the sweet potatoes. Just give it a mixy mix until the flavor, the smell really comes out, right?
2 minutes passed by. Really starting to smell gingery. What do you think? It smells good in here, right?
Smells great.
Yeah, all right, it's low heat, so I'll turn it up to like medium low, and we're gonna add in our shallots. Shallot, I don't know how to pronounce that. Because when you add vegetables to something that's starting to, you know, burn a little bit, they have a lot of moisture in them, and that what that does is it deglazes the pan, and liquid will always remove anything that's burning or starting to, you know, get a little risky, you know? Okay. And normally, you know, when you're cooking potatoes, you like to steam them first, but it's actually the reverse in this technique where we're gonna steam it last. And you'll see, it's part of the deglazing process. Okay? So we'll let that cook down, medium heat, just for a few, like 30 seconds. And I'm gonna turn it up to high heat so we can get, like, you know, some burn marks on here, you know, really start to build up a fond. And the fond is what we deglaze to create flavor, so. If you watch my other videos, you'll see I talk a lot about that stuff. Alright, so let's add in sweet potatoes. So in the meantime, we're looking at what are we going to add to this. Personally, I love a little dash of cardamom. It's like this flowery sort of, I think it comes from a flower, I'm pretty sure. It's a pod normally, and they use it a lot in Indian cooking. And some Chinese five spice, which has, what does it have in it? Star anise, clove, cinnamon, fennel, and black pepper. It really has that typical, like, Chinese flavor. And I'll have some soy ready to go. Tiny bit of chipotle chili. Flipping is fun. It's not really, you know, it helps. But it's good to have a spoon to mix everything around to really get the burnt bits removed. Also, never use a metal spoon on a Teflon coated pan. You will destroy your pan if you do that. I've seen it and it makes me cringe. I've actually done it in my past video and it makes me cringe. Don't do it. But with made-in pans, I'll link it down in the description. These don't have any Teflon coating, so you could literally, and you never have to worry. So that's why I highly recommend these for if you're, you know, gonna be using something metal on metal, you know. Never put metal on Teflon. PSA. So, I'll grab a little bit of salt to season it all up. You don't need to go too crazy if you're adding soy. Tiny bit of chipotle, just to give it a little spice. And then the classic Chinese five spice going in. Gives it this like really interesting smell. Like if you buy this, you'll see what I mean. And some cardamom. Feel free to exclude some of these ingredients and experiment for yourself. If you want to just do soy, that's all you. This is just me having fun, you know? Boom. Very light on cardamom because it could be very overpowering if you add too much. And it's also powdered, it's not the pod, so it doesn't infuse the same way. So now we can see it's starting to get a little nerve-wracking, how it's starting to burn a little bit. So we're just about there. Wow, it's strong. The pepperiness. Alright. So when deglazing, the soy sauce is not enough. It's like too salty on its own. So we're gonna add a little bit of water along with the soy sauce. So I'll have that ready to go. And what's basically gonna happen is it's gonna get all the flavor, the burnt stuff, off the pan. And when we cover it with our rusty old pan, our sheet pan, it's gonna allow it to steam and really fully cook down so you don't have, like, you know, chewy raw bits of potato. So it's just starting to get there. Make sure the heat is really high so you can get a little bit of burning, kind of like a potato hash, but not really. All right, I'd say it's just about time. So we'll start with our soy sauce, which will instantly evaporate. Instantly add the water, turn the heat off, cover it. You don't want that steam to escape. So the heat is off, so it's not gonna, you know, keep cooking too much, but it will steam, and after say like 30 seconds, you know, everything's chilling out, you can turn the heat back on and put it on low. So we'll let that steam for about like a minute, and honestly, a minute to 2 minutes, just taste it, see if it tastes cooked, and that's how you know. Always taste, a good chef, a good cook, always taste their food. Let's take a look at the duck. It's 11:30, it's been almost exactly an hour. We put it in around an hour ago, and probably shouldn't touch that. It's getting there. It's not fully crispy. Like, I mean, it's definitely fully cooked at this point, but it's not the crispiness that I want it to be at. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put it back, and we'll turn the heat up to 400. That way it can really start to crisp. And if we have to turn the heat up more, we'll do that. But I want crispy skin, that's what I'm going for. So probably another 30 minutes. An hour and a half is probably right, okay? Let's check on our potatoes now. And also, always have a rag or something on you so you don't burn yourself. It's a good instinct to just naturally wrap. Take a look at that. It's nice and softened up. Heat is low. And you can also sort of assist the deglazing process and just push it over and scrape that those bits too. Really just to get all that flavor incorporated, right? It's looking really good. And it's also cut really small. That also helps with cooking the potatoes really fast. So, let it cool. It's hot. I don't want to burn my tongue right now.
Don't do it.
The amount of times I've eaten food so fast, I'm just like, ah!
Relax, straight out of the pan.
Gotta relax, gotta relax.
Straight out of the pan.
Oh, man. Ooh. Oh, wow. So, yeah, there's a little kick to it. That will definitely, I mean, it could use a little sweetness, so I think we're gonna probably toss it in with a little bit of hoisin. Just because it's really gingery, really strong, it comes on too strong, a little sweet will sort of counteract with all that intensity, you know? So I added just like a teaspoon of hoisin, and this is what, like maybe a 3/4 cup, something like that, maybe a cup. Just really scrape it in. Don't force anything. In life, you never want to force anything, right? And we'll just sort of mix that all together very delicately. And you'll have a nicely hoisin-coated little sweet potato topping. And that is our first topping for our really intense duck omelet. Very different. If you've ever tried duck and eggs together or had a duck omelet of any sort, I would love to hear about it. Comment down below. Otherwise, just tell me what your favorite omelet is. Maybe I can make it or make my own version of it. Who knows? Okay. For our next topping, I'm not even gonna clean the pan. I'll turn the heat back on really low. So this stuff, this fond doesn't burn. And we'll just add our shiitake mushrooms right away. And the mushrooms will begin to sweat out, and that will help with the deglazing process and really bring in more flavor. So we'll just spread that out. And if it does start to burn, you can add a little bit of water to aid the deglazing process. Always do what seems right. So we're just mixing that together just until it's fully sweated out. There's a little color going. Probably give it another few minutes, like one or two. And once that pan is, you know, just about deglazed, you can really start to turn the heat off because you don't have to worry too much about any more deglazing. It's really just cooking it down. Dash of salt. Always taste it. Don't add too much. Too much is always a problem of anything. And I'd say we're just about there. So quick shake, turn the heat off. We'll just let that chill for a bit. Just gonna do a little bit of sesame oil. And we'll add our cabbage straight in, just like that, right? You don't wanna cook it too much because then it's just gonna be too mushy. You want a nice little crispness to it. Crispness to it. Let that cook very quickly.
Yeah, I mean, it's really simple. And we'll turn the heat up to high. We're gonna be really quick with this. So everything we have here, we have a little bit of umami, we have a little bit of sweetness and intensity. I think what we're missing now is a little bit of acid. So I'm gonna add a little bit of lemon juice, right? Very little. Actually, we'll go a little heavier. Tiny bit of honey. Not too crazy, just to enhance it. And our soy. Quickly cover that up. Give it a shaky shake. We'll turn the heat down. You know what? We'll turn it off. Turn it off. And we'll let that cook for literally 30 seconds, and that's how quick it is. We don't want to have overcooked cabbage. It has to be cooked so it's nice and crispy and you have some texture, because we don't have anything else that's really crispy going into here. That's the final of all of our ingredients. And we just want to let that liquid evaporate real quick into the cabbage. Another 30 seconds, maybe we'll just bring it back up to high heat. Sorry about all these directions. I hope it's not confusing at all, but. No, really just play around with it. This is your playground, you do whatever you want. If you want to do something differently from how I say, go there. Just go there, all right? Because essentially, I'm giving you the ingredients, you do whatever you want with it. If you want to follow the way I do it, I'm just having fun. When you have fun, it always comes out a lot better. So, just about deglazed, everything's just about evaporated, flavor's in there. Put that aside. All toppings are done. The duck is looking really nice and crispy, probably another 10 minutes. And I got 4 eggs in the blender, so I'm just gonna gently blend them. Don't wanna incorporate too much air, that's perfect. So we'll just set that up. Also, I forgot, it's probably a good idea to add a little bit of salt. Just throw that in there. All we gotta do is shred that duck.
Asian.com, and you get your reaction.
Wow. Waking up to this.
Alright guys, that was almond. I tried it yesterday. It was delicious. If you want to see more videos like this, make sure to subscribe and check out my other channel down below. Peace.